I'd like to ask you about something I often feel, and that's feeling frightened. I don't even know what I'm frightened of. It's just feeling terrified. And I try and look at it as something that's part of me or as energy. Perhaps I can handle it more now, but it's still very present and very frightening.
You won't figure it out until it doesn't stop you anymore. Trying to understand it stops you from stepping into it.
I often try to not to avoid it, just to feel it as much as possible, to let it take over. But I think I do that only to accept it away. So it's as if I accept it, so it will go as quickly as possible, but
it doesn't need to go away. It only needs to not stop you anymore.
It often leaves me feeling very vulnerable and judgmental towards its presence.
Sweetly vulnerable and not at all in any way judgmental. Let your heart live in that vulnerability, not needing covering or a safety. And you'll be realizing the deep in your heart.
I often need that protection towards other people who I feel need a lot from me, and I feel I need to set some kind of boundary, or because otherwise there'll be nothing left, up to the point of exhaustion.
Set a boundary, but not in your heart. Your whole heart can stay beautifully vulnerable.
I think part of me being frightened is feeling lost. If I'm on the right track, how do I continue? Feeling nothing to ground me. Different spiritual practices. A very great sense of being lost in all of this. Trying to surrender to it, but not succeeding.
You don't need the ground you think you need.
But there are so many patterns that need the ground, that rely on it, and it seems like losing the patterns is impossible. They just run what's going on. They run the show, these patterns. Even if I can see them, I can see them rising and doing what they do, and I'm trapped in them.
You're trapped by your own belief. You won't believe the deepest within that you know the truth of. So then you'll believe everything other than that. And that makes your patterning powerful. Only give your belief to the deepest within that you know the truth of. It won't be a personal truth. It'll be a level within that's deeper than your personality, deeper than your patterning, deeper than yourself.
Can that come out, that level? It seems so deep.
If it has all of your belief, yes. If it doesn't have your belief, it doesn't have you. Your patterning, the patterning in yourself, has had you. Because you have given it your belief.
Would moving to a different environment where people are less dependent on me. Would that help?
You don't need that. You need to give all of your belief, your real power, to the deepest within that you know the truth of. You'll be giving your power to direct knowledge within that will not offer you a feeling of groundedness in yourself, that will not offer you a consolation to the experience of vulnerability. It won't offer you anything. You will be offering it everything. And you'll live that way. Live that way, and you'll have it right. If you don't live that way, you'll have it wrong. Not according to your beliefs, not according to anything in your thinking, but according to knowledge, to direct knowledge within.
I'm not sure I'm capable of that.
What's to stop you?
Everything around. The minute you step outside, it's all there, all the time.
And how does it stop you?
It obscures.
You use it to obscure. You use that to make your own patterning understandable, instead of making direct knowledge within understandable.
Is meditation a good way to experience direct knowledge or to gain access to direct knowledge?
You don't need to experience it. You already know it. There isn't anything that deserves your belief as much as direct knowledge within. The deepest within that you already know the truth of. You need to live that knowledge. Living that knowledge will be at cost to yourself. It comes at personal cost. That's what you have used to stop you. Everything that you've made understandable hasn't excused you.
How about being present? Does that? I find it very difficult to stay present. I find I'm constantly thinking about what I'm going to do next or what's going to happen next.
Whatever has your belief has your presence. Your belief is, as awareness, your greatest power. And that power belongs in direct knowledge. There is no getting around that. Your real home isn't your patterned self. It isn't your thinking. It isn't your feeling. Your real home is the deepest within that you know the truth of. Your real home, your only home, is direct knowledge. As awareness, surrender completely to being that direct knowledge. The cost of that on every level is incidental.
Thank you.
If you're separate from direct knowledge within, you'll be separate in everything.